Hi everybody, this is Bhupati Raj, Mantra IAS Academy, Hyderabad, and today's topic, data sufficiency, one of the important topics of all the competitive examinations, especially for our IAS preliminary examination contest, CSAT 2. And basically I can do here, first of all I can give you the models of this one, and you can have 5 options for every exam, every question. In fact, option A, option B, option C, option D and option E, and otherwise some cases 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 options. In this particular topic, what we call the data sufficiency, we have to mark the answers in a different style. That means what? Example, I can go with the direct question. A question is given to us, what is the value of X? What's the question there, please? The first bit is, what's the value of X? And followed by 2 statements. The first statement is what? X plus 15 is equal to 25. The second statement is X minus Y is equal to 45. Imagine this is a, of course, very wonderful question here. Please observe, a question, in fact, in the examination, what it could be actually, what is the value? What is the value of X? This is a question actually. This is the first statement and second statement. Each and every question of the data sufficiency followed by 2 statements. The 2 statements called as data. And you can say data is in the form of what? Two statements. By using the statements, that is called as first statement and second statement, we have to solve the question. That is the basic point of the data sufficiency. In this case, the logic is very important. Please observe the logic very carefully. If you answer the concerned question, of course, concerned given question, if you answer it by using the first statement, if you get the answer by using the first statement, but not, of course, by using second. In fact, if the second statement is not at all useful to solve the question, then we have to mark the answer as A. I am repeating that. If you get the answer by using one alone, only one statement you have to utilize here. That means what? If you take the second statement, it should not be useful to answer the question. If you get the answer by using first statement alone, then we have to mark the answer as A. And if you get the answer by using second statement alone, we have to mark the answer as what? B. Please observe the process in this case. It is a very, very important part. And if you understand this particular topic, you can do many questions easily in the logical applications. See that if you get the answer by using the first statement alone, option A. If you get the answer by using second statement alone, option B. Now what is C set? Option C must be in a different case. You should not get the answer by using, of course, you should not get the answer by using first statement and second statement alone. That means what? Individually, you should not get the answer by using these 2 statements. One point is clear. Then what? By using the 2 statements, by using the 2 statements together, or else by using 1 and 2 statements together, clubbing, or otherwise all mathematical operations, if you get the answer, then we have to mark the answer as C, provided you have to go to the option C in a very special condition, that you should not get the answer individually. That means what? You should not get the answer as A, you should not get the answer as B. Then only we have to club the 2 statements, please. It's a very important point. So what is D now? D is, that is what? Data, first statement, data in the form of second statement. You should not get the answer by using the 2 statements individually, even after clubbing also. That means what? The given data is insufficient. The topic name is what, please? Data sufficiency. The given data is insufficient to solve the question, then we have to mark the answer as D. And very specific case, please remember E or 5, option E or option 5 is, you should get the answer, you should get the answer alone from both the statements. Alone from both implies what? You should get the answer by using first statement. At the same time, you should get the answer by using second statement also. Don't be in confusion. Just after telling 5 examples, you can become perfect in this case. Now, I am repeating the first question. See that, what is the value of X? First statement is X plus 15 is equal to 25. Second statement is X minus Y is equal to 45. Now, I can solve the question. Now, what is the answer here? The question is, what's the value of X? First statement is X plus 15 is equal to 25. We can get the answer directly by using the first statement, that X plus 15 is equal to 25 indicates But the value fix 25 minus 15, it gives us what? 10. Then what is the value of x means? We are getting the answer by using first statement now and only. And now your duty to check up the second statement also. If you get even from the second statement and only, then we have to mark the answer as E. Otherwise, our option is A only. Now I got the option as what? X plus 15 is equal to 25. Because of this reason, I got X is equal to 10. Indicates by using first statement, I got the answer is A. In fact, whenever you get the answer, there is a chance of getting E also, please. E is nothing bad. You should get the of answer by using second statement also. Because I am taking much time for the introduction, it's very important point that I know. Because if you understand the basic fundamental concept, you can do every question very easily now. Now just check the second statement. Now my question is, what's the value of x? Can I get by using x minus of y is equal to 45, please? No, not possible. Because we have one extra variable called as x minus of y is equal to 45. So that I need to know what I need a value here. That is y actually. I don't have the value of y. So I can't get the value of x by using second statement. So second statement is not at all useful for this concern question. So means what? We are getting the answer by using first statement alone. So this answer is what, please? A. And some people can get the doubt, sir, why it's not C, sir? Because you simply substitute the value of x here, by that you can get the value of y. And automatically you can tell, no, sir. See, the very important point, many people can do the mistake in the part of C option. C will be taken in only one condition, that you should not get the answer by using first statement alone. You should not get the answer by using second statement alone. Then only we have to club the two statements. Then only we have to go to the option C, please. So don't say option C for any question. Now in this case is what? X plus 15 is equal to 25. I got the value of x is equal to 10 by using first statement. Because of that reason, my answer is A. Over. I am going to take the second example, please. I can take 5 examples now. By that you can understand the concept of data sufficiency. Now here, what is the value of x, Baba? First statement is x minus y is equal to 30. Second is what? X plus 5 is equal to, imagine, some 20. Same style, each and every data sufficiency question consists of a question followed by two statements. The two statements is nothing but, in this particular case, of course, the student, two statements are what here? The data, or you can say, data is in the form of statements. Now, target is same, style is same, application is same. Can we get the answer by using first statement, please? Impossible, because x minus of y is equal to 30. So by using first statement alone, it's not possible, because we have one extra variable called as y. So our answer is what? Not A. When option is not A, obviously you cannot get the option as what? E also. So there is a chance of getting the answer for this question is what? Chance of B or C or D. Now B means I should get this answer by using second statement alone. Can I get by using second statement? That's my target now. X plus 5 is equal to 20 indicates x is equal to what, Baba? 20 minus 15. 5 it is. What's the value of this? X is equal to 15. How I get the answer here? I got the answer by using the second statement. Because of that reason, now second statement alone give the answer for this concern question. My option is what now? B. Now I'll go to the third model. The model number 3 here, it's also one of the important questions in fact. Same point. What is the value of x I'm taking? No doubt I can take the same question. What is the value of x? I got the option by using, of course, previously first is what, option A, second question is option B. Now I am going to cover which type of the option C in fact. What is option C and how we can get the option C in this case? Question is same. What is the value of x? First statement is x minus of y is equal to 5. Second is what? X plus y is equal to 25. Imagine that. The first statement is what here, please? X minus y is equal to 5. Second is what? X plus y is equal to 25. What is my target? I should know the value of x actually. Can I get the answer by using first statement, please? The process, particularly data sufficiency topic, I know it is very important topic for many exams. Of course, you are writing civil services examination, it plays a key role. One point is clear. At the same time, for GMAT, all the management entrance examinations, MAT, CAT, GMAT, or any entrance examination, of course, nowadays, people are of course focusing upon this type of concept because it's a mathematical logic. That's the reason. And this type of things also applicable, not only mathematical. They may be asking that a general questions in data sufficiency. That also we are going to cover. It's a very, very lengthy topic. I can cover many questions today. Even if not, I can take out second video also, don't worry. Provided this go through these things, it helps a lot to you, right? Now come to the point. What's the value of x here? X minus of y is equal to 5, x plus y is equal to 25. can I get the answer by using first statement? That's my target. Can I get please? X minus y is what now? 5 it is there. So I don't know the value of y. Because of that reason, I won't get the option as A. In fact, when option is not A, definitely option is not E, please. Then, when you're not getting the first answer by using first statement, in fact, you should go to the second statement. Can you get the answer by using second statement, please? Here also the same problem here. The problem is same implies what? We have one other extra variable here, y. Because of that reason, you can't get the answer. So, your answer is not B. In fact, now the options are what? Not A, not B, not E. You have two options now. Either C or D, please. Now, C means, when we have to, of course, I told you now, when we should write the option as C, that's very important point. If you don't get the option A or B, in fact, if you do not get the answer by using first statement or second statement L only, then we will club the two statements, combine the two statements, adding multiplication to all the mathematical operations. And then you can, if you get the answer, you have to mark the option as C. Now come to the point here. Now I am clubbing the two statements. In fact, I am considering the two statements now. In this case, plus y minus y cancel. 2x is equal, I got, because adding the two statements here, 2x is equal 30, 25 plus 5, x is equal, I got 15. The process here is, after combining the two statements, I got the answer. When this type of things are there, option is C, please. It's a very, very important model for the civil services examination. Now come to the point of model number 4. Same point I am going to cover. Question is same, Baba. I just told you 5 models in this case. Option A, option B, option C, option D, and option E, my dear. Now the point is, what's the value of X here? We have to find out the value of what? X. Now the first statement is, X plus Y plus R is equal to 30. Second is, Y plus Z minus K is equal to 45. Please come to the point here. What's the duty, please? You should tell the option, that's all. You should tell the answer. Actually, in the examination, no need of doing any solution. Only concept of what? Can you get the answer by using first statement? Can you get the answer by using statement? Number two, can you get the answer by using two statements combinedly? Otherwise, can you, of course, given data is not sufficient to answer the question. That is the process here. So, no need of mathematical operations now. Actually, question is what? What's the value of x? X, first statement is that. Style, you know that one. First of all, we'll check the first statement. X plus y plus r is equal to what, Baba? 30. Can you get the answer by using first statement? Impossible, because you have x, y, r, 3 variables are there. It's not possible, single statement and 3 variables. You need 3 equations actually mathematically if I was speaking that. X plus y plus r is equal to 30 implies by using first, I won't get the answer for x. So my answer is what? Not A. Obviously what? Not E also. Then come to the point here. Then when option is not A individually, we should go to the second statement. Can I get the answer by using this? Y plus Z minus K is equal to 45. My question is what, Baba? What's the value of X actually? Right? Can you get the answer by using second? Highly impossible. How and why? Because there is no concept. You cannot find the letter X in this case. No X at all. How can you get the answer? Y plus Z minus K is equal to 45. On which basis you can get the value of X? Impossible. So option B also not correct. Option B also what? Not this concerned option. So now you have the options of only two. That is what? Either C or D option. D is the given data is insufficient to solve the question. Please remember. Now come to the point. I am combining the two statements. If I get the answer, I should write the option as C. Now can I get here? X plus Y plus R, Y plus Z plus K, adding, multiplication, subtraction, anything you do, it's not possible because we have the number of variables here. X, Y, R, Z, K. How many variables we have? 5 variables. How many equations we have? 2 equations. Impossible. You can't get it. So what you can see now, you need lot of data for this one to solve the question. So given data is not sufficient to answer the question. So your option is what? D. That is what actually. Option A is what? Option B is what? Option C is what? I think you understood what is D also. Now, the final model of this I can cover. After covering fifth model, I will give you very beautiful examples in this one. We can have number of questions. Next, I will go to problem number, model number 5. The fifth model, please. I will just note the question here. What is the value of X? First statement is X minus 1 is equal to 3. X minus 2 is equal to 2 here. The process is same in the topic of data sufficiency. It plays a crucial role, I told you already. Please be cautious. No doubt it takes a little extra time for introduction, but these five questions plays a key role in the complete concept. So you should understand the five models. Of course, I'm going to have so many questions now again. X value is what to find out in this case. First statement is what? X minus of 1 is equal to 3. Can you get the answer by using first? Yes, sir. We can get the value because X is equal to what? 3 plus 1 minus 1 goes to right side. You got the answer by using first statement. How much it is? X is equal to 4. Then individually, if you get the answer by using, we should write the answer A. But we have to check the second statement also. To write the option A, you should not get by using second. If you get the option by using second also, you should write the option as E. That's the case actually. Now my point is over. One point is that the first statement gave me the option as answer as what? X is equal to 4. Now I am going to second statement. X minus of 2 is equal to 2, right? Then what is the value of this? 2 plus 2 is equal to how much you got? 4. In this case also you got the option answer. So in fact, for the concerned question, what is the value of X means, we are individually getting the answer by using first statement and second statement also. So whenever you have this type of situations, you have to mark the option as E. This is called data sufficiency, my dear. So please, of course, just go through our website also, mantraias.co.in. This is our website. So we are slowly developing all the concepts and it helps a lot. We are going to have so many things in future. Now website developed, that is mantraias. I just am repeating that mantra, mantraias .in, please. No doubt this is, of course, go through the website also. You can have regular updates, and within days of time, we have taken time to develop the website, and please just go through that one. Now I am coming to the point, the topic sequentially. I'll ask you all the questions now. Of course, I can give the solutions also. Please remember, the data sufficiency plays a key role. I am doing the first question now. Please remember, the first question is, what is the value of X? This is what you call the exercises now. I told models now. First question, what is the value of X? First statement is, 5X minus of 3 is equal to Y, Baba. 5X minus 3 is equal to Y. Second is, X by 10 is equal to 1 by 5. Please tell me the answer, what is that actually? Can you get the answer by using first statement, please? First of all, whenever you can have an expression, of course, algebraic expression, you should make it in a proper format. Proper format is what? 5x and bring this y to left side minus y is equal to 3. Now, can you get the answer by using first statement? Because I wrote in the proper format of algebraic expression that 5x minus y is equal to 3. Can you get the option? Can you get the answer by using this first statement? No, because we have extra variable y. So our answer is not A. When answer is not A means E also not the answer. Then come to the point of second statement. X by 10 is equal to 1 by 5. This gives you X by 10 implies what? X is equal to 10 by 5 by cross multiplication. 5 ones are, 5 twos are. You got the answer by using second statement. Because of this reason, what's the answer now? This is what? You got the option only by using second statement. Because of this reason, option is B. Now second question. Yeah, my dear, the second question is very important. Just observe the logic point in this. But a very important point I am asking you that. The question, first of all, what is the age of Rajesh? Question is what? Focusing area, what's the age of Rajesh? To find it, you of course, you need two statements. Statement A is there, statement B is there. But actually, we are following that now. Statement 1 and statement 2, I can go. Otherwise, you'll be confused. Then come to the point. First statement is, Rajesh, Jyoti, Kiran are all of the same age. That indicates what? If you know one person's age, automatically Rajesh is same age, the same as Kiran, and any of out of three, if you know one, you can tell the age of them definitely. Then see, second statement is, total age of Jyoti, Kiran and Abhilash is 32, and Abhilash is as old as Jyoti and Kiran. This I can, same style, I'll come from the first statement. Can I get the answer by using the first statement? That's the basic point. Can I get the option here, please? Because, what is that? Rajesh age is same as Jyoti's age and Kiran's age. So, I don't know what's the age of Jyoti by using first statement. Definitely, I don't know what's the age of Kiran in this case, at the same time, basic question Rajesh also. Any of these three, at least if you know one's age, automatically we can tell the answer. But by using first statements, I'm not getting the option. So I don't know any of them, the age particularly. So option is not A, option is not E also. Then please go to second statement. What is second statement here? Total age of Jyoti, Kiran and Abhilash. Come to the point. Jyoti plus Kiran plus Abhilash is how much? 32. Now, can you guess the answer by using this statement, please? Because I need to know the value of Rajesh, actually the age of Rajesh. But data is upon what? Jyoti, Kiran and Abhilash. So it's also not possible. In this case, one important data is that. And Abhilash is as old as Jyoti and Kiran. Please remember, the total age of Jyoti and Kiran is same as what? Abhilash age. Example, Jyoti and Kiran is some 10 years. Obviously, the age of Abhilash also 10 years. Now, very key point in this case. So, option is not A, not B, because you won't get the answer by using second statement also. In this case, no information about Rajesh. So, option is not A, not B, not E. So, now you have only one point, please. Either C or what? D. C means by using two statements, you should get the answer. Now, come to the point, please. J plus K is Abhilash, right? Jyoti and Kiran's age is what? Equal to Abhilash. So, I can do one thing in this case. I am substituting the value of Abhilash as J plus K. Wherever J plus K is there, I can write Abhilash. Abhilash plus Abhilash is 32. So, two times of Abhilash is 32. So what you can say, age of Abhilash is, now I got it, 16 years. Age of Abhilash is what? Exactly 16 years. So now I am combining the two statements, please. Combined, in fact, see, remember, Abhilash is 16. Because of that reason, J plus K also 16. Very important point. J plus K also what? 16. Now by using the first and second statement, the age of Jyoti, whatever it may be, that equal to Kiran's age. So they have the same age. In fact, J plus K 16 implies J must be 8, K must be 8. Because combined the two statements, I am trying the option C. I got the value of J is equal to 8, K is equal to 8. Therefore, Rajesh also 8. That is a very important question. I will repeat, this is a very important model. What is the age of Rajesh is the question. Statement is that Rajesh, Jyoti, Kiran are all the same age. And total age of Jyoti, Kiran and Abhilash is what? 32. And Abhilash is as old as Jyoti and Kiran. This is a very dangerous data here. Abhilash is as old as Jyoti and Kiran. By using first, it's not possible to get the answer. So option is not A, not E. Then come to the point, J plus K plus AB is 32. But Abhilash is total age of what? J plus K is how much? Of course, it could be 10 or 15. Same is of Abhilash. So J plus K is equal to Abhilash. Wherever J plus K, I can substitute the values Abhilash. Abhilash plus Abhilash is 32. So 2 times of Abhilash is 32 implies the age of Abhilash is how much I got? 16. When Abhilash is 16, J plus K must be 16. But by this data, J is equal to K. Because of that reason, J 8, K 8. When J 8, K 8, obviously what? R also 8. This is what the important part of data sufficiency. Now the third question. Now look at the third question here. It is also one of the good models, please. What is the distance from A to C? What is the focusing area? The question is, I have to find out the distance between A and C. First statement is, now I'm just coming to the point, the first statement is, the distance from A to B is 8 kilometers. Second is, the distance from B to C is 4 kilometers. See, my dear, you are going to write one of the best exams and the toughest examinations in India. No doubt, the highest extraordinary examinations and one among the top examinations. So, they want to check you in different style. Just by looking at the question, chalo, answer to ye ho gaya, likho. Don't say that. Just wait and see the logic, because don't be in a hurry to write the answer. Though if you understand the concept, take minimum seconds gap to write the option. That's a very important point to write the civil service examination. See, A to B is 8 kilometers. What is my question, please? I am not asking you about A to B. My target is, what's the distance between A and C? I have to find out A to C. But what that fellow gave us? A to B. So what? Your answer is, Obviously not A. This is not your answer. Then come to the point of second statement. Second statement is what? B to C. But what is my question, please? It's A to C. Is it sufficient? No. So that when option is not A, E is not the answer, B is not the answer. That means what? Individually, we won't get the answer by using first statement, and individually, we won't get the answer by using second statement. Then you have the option to find C or D. You have to combine the two statements. Here the logic. Very important, please, my youngsters. Because my target is A to C. First statement is A to B and second statement is B to C. What is there, sir? Very simple, sir. We can get the answer. What is there? Option C. Don't say immediately the answer, please. Check it. If it is the case, A to B is 8 kilometers. If B to C is a straight line, definitely you can tell the answer as A to C is equal to 8 plus 4, no doubt 12 kilometers. If this is the condition, if it is a straight line, did he mention that? Did he mention that is a straight line? No, he hasn't mentioned but the distance of straight line or something. So what you can say? A to B might be like this, B to C maybe in this case, I don't know, it's not in straight, he has not mentioned that, of course, it's only straight line. Who are you to take the straight line? So that if this is the case, you will not get the same answer. Example, A to B is okay, you can take 8 kilometers. B to C might be in this manner, how can you design this one without, it means what? If this is the case, one answer. If this is the case, this is another answer. If this is the case, some other answer. Means what? For every question, we should get only one answer. So that the data is not sufficient to answer the question, please. Majority people can write the answer as C for this question, but C is wrong option. So now the data is not sufficient to tell exact answer for this one. What to write here? Answer is D. Next question, please, that is I can go fourth bit. Yeah, my friends, it's a very important question. Please observe this question very carefully and try to tell the answer yourself that when was the theft committed in his house? The question is what, please, here? Logical question. I'll immediately go to the mathematical application, of course, once. When was the theft committed in his house? That's the question. Now you have to answer by using the data that you know very well. In fact, the first statement is the theft was committed 2 hours after the clock 12. Remember, don't be in a hurry, please, because data sufficiency plays a key role in your success. The theft was committed 2 hours after the clock struck 12. Option is, of course, first statement is over. Then go to second statement. The theft was committed 2 hours before the clock struck 4. Any guess? Definitely you people can tell the answer is what? Yeah. I don't know. I can tell you because you have idea about your answer. Now come to the point. Can you get the answer by using first statement? You're feeling that you can get the answer because 2 hours after the clock struck 12 indicates what? 2 o'clock. So we got the answer. 2 o'clock. That means what? You people can keep the option as A. Good. Wait, I'm not telling the answer now. Second one is the theft. Now second, of course, I'm repeating that the theft was committed 2 hours before the clock struck 4. Wonderful. This also same. 2 o'clock. Now please tell me the option. You people are feeling that, sir, we can get by using this and we can get by using this. In fact, option is E. Majority people definitely deciding the option is what? Because you are getting the answer by using first statement only. Obviously, a second statement also. So, you can write the option as E. My friends, E is exactly wrong answer. A wonderful answer is there, of course, observe it. Because, what's the question? You are going to be an IAS officer. There must be wonderful logic with you, please. Each and every point is very careful. You have to observe each and every word very carefully in future. So because of that reason, when was the theft committed in the house? First statement is what? The theft was committed 2 hours after the clock struck 12. No doubt 2 o'clock. My friends, if it's 2 o'clock, is it AM or PM? It's not mentioned. So we don't know. In the morning or midnight or something, of course, the afternoon or the midnight, or you can say, night 2 o'clock or daytime 2 o'clock. AM and PM is not mentioned. So that is not A. Obviously the same thing is not B. So when the time is not mentioned strictly AM and PM, you won't decide when the theft was Coming to date at home implies option is what? Data is not sufficient. So you should say the answer as D. Now next question. Yeah, my dear IAS officers, please observe this is, the question is what? What's the value of X? Followed by two statements. First statement is X squared is equal to 4. Second statement is X plus 2 is equal to 4. No doubt your operation is same. We have to find the answer for this concerned question. I should know the value of X. Can I get the answer by using 1? That is X squared is equal to 4. Can I get the answer by using 2? That is X plus 2 is equal to 4. See, many people can tell the answer that I know. Majority people can tell different answer, but I am going to give you different answer. That is data sufficiency, please. X squared is equal to 4, no sir. What is there in that? Simply X is equal to 2. Majority people can say, because X squared is equal to 4, obviously X is equal to 2. Very good. No doubt. But mathematics is nothing but what a mathematical point. You should look at this particular question in a microscopic manner. Data sufficiency decides the destiny, in fact. So please come to the point. This is of course your destination. Be cautious. X squared is equal to 4. X is equal to what? 2. No, X is equal to not 2. Please remember, X is equal to now. You should write root 4. That value must be plus or minus 2. Not exactly 2. So X is equal to what you can say? I don't know that. But X is equal to plus or minus 2, sir. I'm asking you the question, what's the value of X? You should tell the answer is what? Either 2 or minus 2. But not plus or minus 2. It's not possible. Not acceptable. So, option is not A. Remember, you felt that, of course, definitely I got the answer by using first statement. Not at all. You didn't. X is equal to what? Plus or minus 2. You didn't decide the value of what is it actually X. Then comes the point of second statement. So, your answer is not A. Your answer is not E also. Then comes the point of the second statement. Second statement is a wonderful that X plus 2 is equal to 4. Tell me, what's the value of X? It is 4 minus 2. Obviously, you got the exact answer. Exact answer is that. What is that? X is equal to 2. So, what you can say, you got the answer individually. By using second statement individually, you got the answer. Because of this reason, you would write the answer as what? B. But not this one and that one. Not E answer here. So, I think math is very clear. Upon the same logic, I can tell you one or two questions more. Then, now I can do the little mathematical application. So, I think you understood what is data sufficiency. It's one of the best topics in civil services examination part 2, or you can say paper 2. Next question. Very good question, the sixth one here. What is the value of X? Question is same. Now, the first statement is X squared minus 1 is equal to 0. Second statement is X is equal to 10 to the power of 0, my youngsters. This is very important question. 10 to the power of 0. 10 to the power of 0. I think you understand why this I have repeated a number of times. That is, now question is, I should know the value of X actually. X squared minus 1 is equal to what? 0 indicates X squared is equal to 1. You know that. What is the value of X, please? Definitely plus or minus 1. That means same story. You're not telling the exact answer of what's the value of X actually. Is it plus 1 or minus 1? It's not at all deserved by using first statement. So option is what? Not A. Then go to second statement. Second is X is equal to 10 to the power of 0, please. Anything to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 0 is what? Your wonderful answer is that X is equal to 1. That indicates second statement directly giving the option. Otherwise answer. So you should tell the option as what? B for this question. Next question. I'll go to question number 7, please. Just I can write here, observe it very carefully. What is the value of X? Question is same, Baba. First statement is X squared minus 9 is equal to 0, whereas second statement is X is greater than 0. Very, very wonderful application. You have two statements. Question is same. Style is same. Approach is very important in this part. Can you get the answer by using first statement alone? If so, you should write the option as A. If not, then you should go to the second statement. Then if you get the option by using second statement alone, we should write the option as B. If not, in fact, you are not getting the answer by using 1 and 2 individually, then we should combine the two statements. If you get the option is C. If not, data is not sufficient to answer the question is D. Alone, you can say individually, you should get the answer by using first and second. Then we should mark the answer as E. Now please come to the point. My question is what? What's the value of X? First statement is x square minus 9 is equal 0, x square is equal 9. Tell me what's the value of this. No doubt style says, style is same. X is equal to root of 9. My dear, root of 9 is giving you plus or minus 3, but not directly, please. Of course, we can do in mathematical applications whenever it is needed. We can take 3 square root of the 9 is nothing but 3. But in this case, I told you that data sufficiency microscopic topic. X is equal to plus or minus 3 implies you are not telling the exact answer for what? X. Then go to what? Second statement. Second statement is x is greater than 0. What a wonderful point here. Because it could be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or of course your property 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, so many zeros. I wish you all the best. You should earn this much of money. Properly, but not improperly, please. Very important point. I want to see my youngsters, the whole officers, be in a proper manner. Don't do any nonsense activity. I think you understood what I told you. Now, x is more than 0. Indicates 1, 2, 3, 4. So much of. This is your total property. Otherwise, 1, 0, 0, something is there. Now, tell me what's the value of x. It's not possible. It may be 1, it may be 2, it may be 1.5, it may be 7.5, maybe 1 lakh, 10 lakh or 100 crore. We don't know. By this, second statement is not telling the exact answer for what's the value of x. That means not A, not B. Then what's an option? We should combine the two statements. Please remember, we should combine the two statements, my friends. Then how to do it? Yes, I can tell you. I can just take the space in this case. X is equal plus or minus 3 provided x is more than 0. What to consider? When x is equal plus or minus 3 and x is greater than 0 means what? Definitely, x is positive value. That is x is equal 3. By using two statements, you got the answer for this wonderful question. Your option is what? C. Now, I'll go to the question number. Please, this is a very important question. Now, this is the 8th question, 9th and 10th here. I think you understood the topic is very important. That's the reason I'm extending here without telling minimum questions. It's really, of course, it's not a proper help from my side. So I have decided to help you that I can do definitely. So please watch it and of course, better subscribe if I tell to your friends also. Mantra IAS Academy Hyderabad. It's our YouTube channel. No doubt, I told you, no, it takes, of course, it will be definitely taking you in each and every subject I can help. Provided, just for the little gap occurred previously, but I can cover that answer. Now, x to the power of 4. Y square minus of xy whole square by x cube y square. This is the question. The question is, what is the value of this expression? What is the value of x to the power of 4 y square minus of xy whole square? X cube y square. First statement is x is equal to 2. Second statement is what? Y is equal to 8. Yeah, my officers, tell the answer. Everybody without, of course, thinking a 2-3 seconds of time, simply they can tell the answer as what? C. Yes, C. Exactly C. What C? C is a wrong answer. Exactly wrong, please. Now think in other style. That's the reason I told you in the beginning itself. Now this is an algebraic expression. Whenever you find the algebraic expression in the mathematics in the question paper, you should do. You should do one point that write in a proper manner. Just expand it. Xy whole square is nothing but x squared y squared by x cube y square, right? You know, algebraic applications, simplification is very important point. Simplify the point now. Take y square as common, x square minus, x power 4 minus of x square by x cube y square, right? y square is out. Now we have the expression is x to the power of 4 minus of x square by x cube. Even if you expand, that is our taking of x square common or something, x square common, we can get, of course we can expand this, but no need of doing that one, because solution is not the matter, just keeping the option is the matter in this topic. Now, which statement do you need? Do you need this x is equal to 2, or you want y is equal to 8 now to find the question? Or you need both? In the beginning you thought that, of course, we need both, but now after solving in a proper manner, We need only one expression, otherwise one variable, that is x. X is equal to 2 is enough. By substituting, we can get the answer. No need of substituting and no need of telling also. This is enough to tell the answer. Second statement is not at all useful. So what you can say? for this type of question is A. Even if you need, that is called as 2 to the power of 4 minus of 2 square by 2 cube. You can get the answer by solving this. So what is the point in this case? Y is immaterial. By looking at the question, you just feel that we need Y also. But after solving this, what solving the question, Y is out in the problem. So only the variable existed is what? X. Because of that, is that reason. But question number 8, first statement is sufficient to answer the question. Now what is the option, please? A is the right answer. Very good. Then come to the point of 9th question. This is a very wonderful logical question, my youngsters. What is the total number of unemployed people? Please listen to the question very carefully. What is the total number of? The focusing word is what? Total number, you have to find out. So each and every word, each and every letter in the examination paper, please observe the question paper very carefully. Your observation will help you a lot. You will be definitely successful, but provided you should read the question properly. That is what here. What is the total number of unemployed people? First statement is 30% of the total number of unemployed are the educated unemployed. In the data, what is that? The first statement, 30% of the total number of unemployed are the educated unemployed. Then second is what? The remaining are the uneducated unemployed. Very good. Now come and tell me the answer. Please remember, the question is important, the point of data sufficiency. What is the total number of unemployed people? That means you should know the total population. In this case, number of educated people, number of uneducated people. Can you have this information? 30% of total number of unemployed are educated. Okay, fine thing. What is the total population? Out of how many people this much? So you don't know the total population, number one. Second statement, the remaining are the uneducated. Wonderful thing. Definitely. So we don't know the total population. Separation is not there. So not at all. The two statements are not sufficient to answer the question. By using one, we won't get. By using two, we won't get. That means not A, not B, not E. Even after combining the two statements also, not getting. That means what? To find the solution for this concerned question, data is insufficient. So you should mark the answer as what, please? D. Now 9th question is over, please. Then go to 10th bit here. 10th question. What is the time on a certain watch? See, it could be general studies paper 1 or paper 2. But question paper reading is very important here. It could be of mathematical application or common application. So, please read that. What is the time on a certain watch? Indirectly, what is the time on a watch? That's the number one question. First statement is, the minute hand is at 6. Please remember, this is minute hand is at what? Now we are going to have a very beautiful topic, of course, that is called as what? Clocks and calendars that I can cover. But now, 6 o'clock. The minute hand is at what? 6. Mean this is the minute hand, the lengthier or the longest hand, the longer hand. You can say this is at 6. Can you find the answer? Can you tell me what is the time now? It shows up at 7:30. It could be 1:30, 2:30, 3:30 or 7:30. So, not possible by using first statement. So, what is that? Your answer is not A. Then go to second statement, please. Second statement is, the hour hand is, then when you are reading the second statement, you should then focus upon the first. Just forget it. Now focus upon this only. If you don't get by using second statement, then you have to club, then you have to check up the first one, and then you have to consider this one. Means, first of all, individually you have to check the first one, individually second one. If you don't get, then combine the two statements. Now, second, when I am looking at the second statement, I should simply what? Cover this one. The hour hand is exactly at, the hour hand is exactly the very dangerous word, please, exactly halfway between 9 and 10. The hour hand is between 9 and 10, Baba. What is this hand? Hour hand. What about minute hand, sir? See, the condition of watch, when it has come in between of 9 and 10, the minute hand automatically it has to come, it of course come to a point of 6, please. Otherwise, it's not called as watch. So, whether this given or not immaterial for us. By using second statement, we are telling what's the time. Just exactly what is important here, that is between 9 and 10 indicates 9:30. What is the time on a certain watch? It's 9:30 by using second statement. First statement is not needed. So what do you can write now? The option is B. That's a very beautiful question. Now come to the point of 11th question, please. Right. Now the 11th question here, I am reading 11th question, please. Who is the brother of B? Remember, I told you already many times, of course, I am telling in my video classes that very important point is to read the question properly. Who is the brother of B? I'm talking about what? Who is the brother of B? I should tell if anybody is there of B's brother, that I should tell it. Now, first statement is B is A's brother. Second is what? B's father is the husband of A's mother. Now, please tell me the answer. Don't tell the option as A, please. Because a very dangerous point, I want to tell who is the brother of B but not A. What is the first statement? B is A's brother. Brother of A is B. But what is my question? Who is the brother of B? So, B is A's brother indicates B's pakka brother. In fact, male run. A is what? This is a chance of sister also. Male or female, we don't know what's up. This is what A actually. She may be sister here as a brother of B. So that B is A's brother, but A may be sister or brother. So we can't tell the option. So not A by using first. It's not possible to get the answer. Then second, B's father is the husband of A's mother. They have the same parents, of course. A and B has the same parent. That also not sufficient to tell the answer. See that. Now my target is what? Who is the brother of B? Jo hai B ke baare mein uska bhai kaun hai? That is a very important point here. So here, it's not possible by using individually one and two. Now combine the two statements. Can you get by using two statements, please? Impossible. Because I don't know the what is the concept of A. She may be male or female. I don't know that. Because of that reason, I won't tell who is the brother of B. So option is what? Data is not sufficient to answer. So you should tell the option is what? D. That's 11th question. No doubt I am taking the deal because it's a very important topic. If you understand this one, you can do many questions easily. Thereafter you can find, of course, statements and course of action, statement conclusion, logical deductions, many topics. If you understand this ABCD model, you can do that. Now question number 12, please. One more mathematical point. Mathematical question is, what is the value of x? 3x minus y is equal to 24 is the first statement. X plus y is equal to 10 the second statement. Question is what, please? What is the value of x? 3x minus y is equal to 24. Can you get the answer, please? Definitely not. Because we have extra variable y. So your answer is not A. Then go to second statement. In this same story, x plus y. Y is also another variable. So this is also not a second one. In place what? Your answer is not A, not B. Then combine the two statements, please. Yes, by combining, we are getting the answer. This is what you can say, plus y minus y cancellation. 4x is equal to 34. X is equal to what? 34 by 4. 2, of course, that is you can say 17 by 2. Or you can say 8.5. No end up doing the answer, please. By looking at the question, you should tell the answer. By using two statements, we are getting the answer. So, answer is what in this case? C bar. Then, last and final question, I can just tell you data sufficiency. Because I have covered many models here. Don't worry the number of questions, but models which I have, the style of doing is very important because already it's 40 plus minutes. So, you can definitely plan this one here. What is the non-voting population of a country? Now here, what's the non-voting population of a country? First statement is, only males over 20 years of age are permitted to vote. The condition is what? He should be a male. At the same time, he should cross 20 years of age. How many members are there, my dear, in that? No data is not clear, so one is not the right answer, not A. Then go to second statement. The country has a population, total population of 5 crores. Wonderful. But in that case, how many are eligible to vote? What's now? And how many are not at all? Of course, so that what's non-voting population means we don't know by using second answer. Not A, not B, not E. Then your duty is what? Combine the two statements. Even after combining, of course, also. We won't tell the exact answer for this one. So, not C indicates the data is not sufficient to answer the question. Then what's your option, please? D. This is what you call my youngsters, a data sufficiency. Yeah, of course, a very important point I've covered. Please go through that one. If you don't understand, repeat just what, watch it again. By that, you can do definitely the question. Without data sufficiency, it's not. I mean, I can tell you in many, how many exams, of course, these type of things are there. GMAT, MAT, CAT. For these examinations of employment, in fact, bank POs plays a key role. Of course, this topic plays a key role in bank PO examination. Staff selection commission, you will take any exam, Baba. Data sufficiency is very important. Just go through that one and subscribe to this wonderful channel, Mantra IAS Academy Hyderabad. And I wish you all the best. God bless you. We'll meet, of course, in the next class.